Today I'd like to talk to you about collecting nematode samples. Some of you may not know what nematodes are. If you're watching this video, you probably do. But if you don't, nematodes are round microscopic worms that feed primarily on plant roots. Symptoms of nematode infection include yellowing, wilting, and general decline of plants. The problem is most of those symptoms are exactly like other plant pathogens, so you may be confused with other pathogens causing problems to your plants. Nematodes are very common in the Florida landscape. Some of the sampling tools that we use for nematodes include the pogo stick. Our inspectors use this tool. You won't be able to find that on the market. Simple hand trowel or a spade. A spade works perfectly well for collecting samples. Depending on what size of plant you're going to be sampling, such as a small potted plant or a larger potted plant, you may choose to use different types of tools, as I showed you before. For the smaller plants, up to maybe 4 gallons, you can use a simple hand tool. For a lawn sample, you could use just a general spade or shovel. That's not critical at all. When you take your samples, you want to take from the potted plants, you want to be able to take soil and roots from the plants so that you get a representation of either the smaller plant or the larger plant. But make sure that you have soil and roots in your sample that you're submitting. When sampling from a lawn, make sure to take your sample from areas that have declining and healthy turf, and make sure to include roots in the sample with the soil. The sample size should be about the size of a grapefruit. And you also want to include a submission form. When you include the submission form, make sure not to place that in the bag, as the moisture in the soil will be absorbed by the submission slip and we will not be able to read it. On the submission slip, you should include any useful information that's important to where the sample was collected. Also, contact information is very important, especially an email address, as that's where we will be sending the final report of your nematological analysis.